question. In the law, it says within the three business days that they have to reply to you. I live in Pauling.
Airports.
And the airport authority, I put in my email request on one day. And on the third day, they respond to me via mail. So I don't actually receive it to the fourth or fifth day. But the actual documentation is dated the third day. So they're saying, and I've questioned that, and they're saying that they have responded within the 3 days.
I think even though I agree and I would be very dissatisfied like you, they're probably okay on that. It's unfortunate, particularly since you and I both know they could have emailed, scanned in, and emailed the stuff. But yeah, as long as they do it inside of 3 business days. You know, one of the questions that I deal with all the time as an agency, statute's written technically when 3 days from when you mail it. That's not really practical. A lot of agencies are dating their response from when they receive it. But I do think in your case, they're okay on that. I'm sorry.
Yeah, I did too. Got another one. Need to add another note to that one. That they are not in possession. They are not in possession of the records as per requested.
That's a good question. They're all good questions. That's something that I have struggled with. To extrapolate, the question is, so you send your request to the agency and they say, and you know the records exist, but they say it is not in our possession. I think you can handle that in any number of ways. In your case, did they tell you who has possession of it?
They say it's not in their possession.
There are no records responsive to your request.
Which is probably the most typical response that you're going to get. And you're going to find out a lot of times it's not as much about the record as it is about the request. But they will look for technicalities, they will look for loopholes, they will look more oftentimes than not for a reason why there's no record responsive to your request. Now, I'm not giving you the answer that open government advocates want, or the answer that media wants, or the answer that residents or citizens want. But what I'm telling you is that we have got to understand that our intent is to get the record. What you're after is the record. And we should never do what we do. And I'm not saying that anyone sort of has this mindset, but we should never do what we do for the purpose or the intent of saying gotcha. And it's not a cat and mouse game. But the intention is that the record is a public record and we want access to the record. A day or two delay should not happen. The response should happen within the mandated period. A production letter is not a record. However, we've got to make sure that we pick our battles and fight the good fight and create a culture of openness. And that's one of the reasons, by the way, that we want to conduct these symposiums across the state, because you guys are the foot soldiers. And you need, and I'm going to talk a lot more about this as the day develops, but you need to help incubate this culture and this environment where there is an expectation that those records will be produced and that they will be produced in a timely fashion and they'll stop looking for the loopholes. But we're not there yet. We do not have that culture in Georgia, and we don't have that culture in most of our communities. I do need a volunteer, but there's a few caveats that go with volunteering for this. First of all, you can't be a current or former employee of mine. And secondly, you've got to, you can't be involved in the Transparency Project or the First Amendment Foundation. And third, you've got to have a very high personal ethical code. So, who wants to volunteer? Most of us, very ethical. Okay, what I want you to do is I want you to look at the contents of this envelope, shield it from your neighbors there who are all really nosy and like to look over people's shoulders. Eventually, it'll everything be disclosed. And at the appropriate time, which is much later, I want you to do what you think is ethically correct based on the information that you read in the envelope. Okay, we are going to transition the discussion into a discussion.